Many of our YouTube channel subscribers have access to future ultrasound guided subclavian vein cannulation. So here it is. In the video, I will describe step by step how to identify the subclavian vein and insert the triple lumen catheter safely. During the AIDS pandemic, I had performed countless subclavian vein cannulations using landmark technique. Therefore, as someone who has experience with both ultrasound and without ultrasound guidance with this technique, I will say that unless you are very proficient with the ultrasound and have impeccable hand-eye coordination so that you can keep the needle tip in view at all times, ultrasound may be associated with more risks than landmark-based techniques. So there you have it, I stuck my neck out. But unless you're proficient with ultrasound, you may be better off with the landmark-based techniques. In the video, I will also describe the use of a new easy cover one-piece universal procedure drape that allows simple application, monitoring of the patient, and it has a pocket for the storage for the immediately necessary equipment such as guide wire and a sterile ultrasound probe. Also see the use of the easy cover probe cover with a stop sign to remind the practitioners to perform the final checklist at the point of care to prevent wrong procedure on a wrong patient or a wrong side. Throughout the video, I will stop and start the video to focus on specifics of the procedure and the equipment. And don't forget to decrease the tidal volume in patients who are intubated and mechanically ventilated. Okay, let's get started. So what we see here is a typical central line set that is on a tray. Here we can see fluid for irrigation. That is the needle that we're going to use to insert into the subclavian vein. Then we're going to pass the guide wire through that needle in order to place the guide wire and keep it securely inside the lumen of the vein. That is a dilator which comes next so we can dilate the skin through which the triple lumen or central line catheter is going to pass. Let's take a look at this. So typically the procedure starts with preparing the tray, but also now we have to use sterile drapes in order to create a sterile field through which we're going to work. I absolutely hate these. These are like a three pieces that are highly sticky and difficult really to position and take off. So we're going to also demonstrate how you can improve that process by using something that we call easy drape or universal drape that allows you to store the equipment as well. So let's watch this. So that's the equipment. You can always pause the video and watch it. And we start by preparing the patient. This is a very sterile procedure, so everything has to be sterile. Now watch this. This will replace those three pieces that we just talked about as a drape. So this is an easy drape. It has a very clear label as to what goes cranially. So wherever you position the head, that's how the drape is going to be oriented. All we do is peel off one piece. Okay. That then opens the fenestration through which we're going to work and position that on the patient exactly over the area that is of interest where we're going to be working at. Now watch this. This is the pocket that is extremely useful because once you get actually access to the subclavian vein with your needle, you don't really want to move away or reach out far to the tray for your guide wire. Your guide wire should be right there at your fingertips in order not to have the needle dislodged. That's one of the most common mistakes is as people get inside the subclavian vein and you get a good blood flow, by the time you reach out to the guide wire, actually you may lose that position of the needle tip inside the vein. So having a guide wire at your disposition immediately in the pocket for the equipment really makes a big difference. It's perfect position. So now that's the guide wire. We're going to prepare it inside the pocket so we don't have to look for it. And here's another advancement that we have made, and these are the easy covers. These are the ultrasound probe covers that are made with a second skin kind of material with a very clear labeling as to what goes where, and with one additional feature which I absolutely love to make sure we don't do a procedure on a wrong patient. I'll talk about that in a little bit. So here's this piece over here is also used, the wrap, to clean the probe and such. So clearly, hand here, probe here, so you never make a mistake. and pull here. So it's a very seamless, quick. Now that is a very important advance in our practice. We have a stop sign so that you cannot actually get any images until you remove that stop sign. So that's a physical barrier that prevents you from obtaining images until you remove it. So because it stops you at the point of care, this is the time where you first assure that it's a correct patient, correct procedure, correct site, and only then you remove that sticker and place it in a visible place so that everybody in the team knows that the timeout at the point of care has been done. So it's a very important feature. So there we go, we do a timeout, and then we go into take off the protective barrier. Okay. Well, the next step is we're going to place the transducer right underneath the clavicle. Underneath the clavicle is where we want to obtain the view of the subclavian vein, and there it is. You can see it's a very thick vein, large wall. And here we're going to do an in-plane procedure. So you can track the needle placement as it goes through different layers and the chest wall muscles. And again, you really want to place it inside the lumen of the vein under direct vision to increase the safety and efficacy of the procedure. And once we do that, as soon as the needle enters the blood vessel wall, you will see we will get a return of blood in the syringe, and that really signifies that now we are in the subclavian vein. Disconnecting the syringe allows us to see the pattern of the blood flow. Clearly, if this was an artery, we were going to see just a gush of blood coming out, but this was not the case in this situation, and even the color of the blood clearly indicates that this is a venous blood. You see, once you get the blood flow in that needle, you really want to keep that needle immobile, and reaching out to a far distance to the tray to get the guide wire can oftentimes result in a dislodgement of that needle. And once that happens, it's really misery. Then you gotta get it, you know, repeated all over again. So having the guide wire in the equipment packet in the easy cover universal drape really makes a big difference. So let's do that. Here you can see the adhesive strip will absorb any blood that may be coming out, so it's kept neat. We place in the guide wire, you know, through the needle, and now take the needle out. So the guide wire is now left inside the subclavian vein. And now what we need to do is dilate the skin around the guide wire. So once you dilate that skin, you can easier place the central lumen catheter, which is softer than the dilator. So let's see how that goes. So the dialer is, I typically use two hands to stabilize this so that the guide wire easily goes into the dilator, and then push both the guide wire and the dilator through the skin to create the passage for the catheter. Now we're going to remove just the dilator, leaving the guide wire inside. And again, two hands technique that helps you stabilize so you don't shake or have, if you have tremors in particular, this can be useful. Now we feed the central lumen catheter over the guide wire, and the catheter and the guide wire will come out from the proximal port here through the brown port in this particular design. And once the guide wire shows up at the tip of the port, now we basically push everything inside the guide wire and the catheter into the subclavian vein. We remove the guide wire, and now is the time to secure the catheter and test the ports. We will not gonna go through the testing of the ports, but it's very important to secure it right here so the catheter actually does not accidentally dislodge. As you can see, it's a really easy and very convenient design that allows you to place the sterile working field through this universal drape and remove it seamlessly, very quickly. And that was it, the ultrasound guided subclavian vein cannulation. And I would love to hear from you how you do this procedure in your practice and any additional tips or tricks that you would like to share with our community here. And if you find our videos useful, feel free to click subscribe and the notification bell icon so you don't miss out on our future videos. Until next time.